But first, Hong Kong. Protests are weighing on the discussions between the U.S. and Chinese trade negotiators. Thousands of demonstrators staged a celebratory rally after President Trump signed legislation aimed at supporting human rights in Hong Kong. China's vice foreign minister called that act a, quote, serious interference in China's internal affairs. He's also urging the U.S. not to implement the legislation in order to prevent any further damage of the relationship between the two countries. Joining us now is William Lee. He is chief economist at the Milken Institute. You also spent many years at the IMF, and we're going to talk about how this might give you a better perspective than the rest of us here. But you also opened the IMF office in Hong Kong. So the fact that the Chinese are not retaliating to the fact that President Trump signed that legislation says what to us?
It says how important trade is to China, because China regards Hong Kong as a domestic political dispute over sovereignty. It's kind of tantamount to DC wanting states' rights, right? And the US or China coming in to say something about whether or not DC representatives should have a right to vote in Congress. And so they're saying that we should stay out of that. And meanwhile, the US legislation says it's really a human rights issue. And this is where the tension is, where the US view is that the domestic political protest in Hong Kong really threatens to become a global phenomenon that threatens the ability of U.S. to do business there, because it puts into question whether China can actually adhere to long-term contracts like the one it signed in 1997 when it took over the Hong Kong from the British and promised that for 50 years they would have one country, two systems. And let me tell you, since the time I've been in Hong Kong as the res rep for the IMF, the tension have just grown, because the Chinese there in Hong Kong are saying we cannot trust the mainlanders, Beijing, to honor their promises. And that is what the U.S. investors are questioning also. If we enter into a trade agreement with them, can we really believe they'll enforce the terms as we agreed upon?
William, let me ask you this, and I ask this question based on the fact that you understand financial stability. That was one of your pioneered efforts at the IMF, global financial stability. I don't know if Hong Kong would be enough to tip the global financial markets into some kind of problem, but the trade war with the United States, we're 16 days from the tariffs potentially going up here in the United States on imported Chinese goods. What do you see happening? Help us understand where we are in the process and the negotiations.
The immediate threat from the tariffs actually is the threat to business confidence. Again, can businesses rely on Hong Kong to be a financial hub, an entry point into China, a way of doing business with China in the way that we've been used to? If we can't rely on that anymore, then businesses are not going to invest. And that's what we're seeing around the world. Globally, CEOs and CFOs are saying we should hold back on our investment plans. We should hold back on any kind of expansion, especially into China, because we don't know what the contract life will be like in the future. And that threatens financial stability, essentially, because Hong Kong is a major regional financial hub. And doing business in Hong Kong means that we could use Western rules to invest in China. And that's a really big access point that's become a major calling card for Hong Kong over the years, and that is being threatened.
Okay, something we talked about earlier in the trade war with China was Huawei. So China's Huawei is preparing to fight an FCC decision to curtail its business with U.S. customers. Now, this is coming out of the Wall Street Journal. The chipmaker is reportedly planning to sue the agency on the restrictions and increased spending on Washington lobbyists. So how far do you think Huawei can get with this effort to stop what we're trying to do here in the U.S.?
Well, Huawei has become a poster child for China's development strategy. That Made in China 2025 program of theirs is to become standard setters for the advanced technologies around the world. And 5G communications is Huawei's sort of a poster child for doing that sort of campaign. What we're trying to do is to say we want to compete in that world, and we're trying to restrict Huawei's ability to be able to essentially what we think is to trade in an unfair advantage, and also potentially introduce national security threats, because Huawei is almost a subdivision of the Chinese Red Army. So those two points of national security and our desire to try to compete with China has become made Huawei into that poster child for legal actions and everything else. I think a better development strategy for the U.S. is to team up with European suppliers like Ericsson and Nokia, and to develop better and cheaper systems to compete head-on-head with the Huawei systems.
William Lee, thank you very much for your perspective here on The Ticker. All the best to you.
Thanks for having me. Happy Thanksgiving.